You know, when I first moved to Chicago, I would look at guidebooks, and it was as if the city ended at Halstead or Ashland. And then after that, it would just, there was like sea monsters or something. It was like, that was the edge of the universe. This changes that. This opens up, you know, a whole swath of the city.
This is great because it connects all of us with one nice path of Park District land connecting neighborhoods. It's connecting communities.
The 606, those are the first three digits of the zip codes that Chicagoans share. And it includes the Bloomingdale Trail at its heart, but also six grade level parks. So the original train tracks were built in 1874 at grade or on ground level.
In 1913, the track was raised on an elevated structure because people were getting hit by the train that was at ground level. As a historian, I kind of like walking the trail and visualizing what this would have looked like back in 1914 and the 20s. You would have seen actually a lot of what you see today. It's a residential neighborhood with scattered factories along the route. So as you walk along the trail, you really get a sense, I think, of what real working class Chicago is.
I think it's really special to have all this for everybody to get on. I started at my house, ran down to the end, turned around, ran back to the other end, came back down to the end, and I'll be stopping at my house. That'll be 7 miles. There's no stop signs, no stop lights. I can just get on here and just run.
And it's more safer than like the streets because with all those cars that are like 4,000 pounds versus a bike 50 pounds.
It's so fun.
If you like stand right there, you will see the view of everything.
This is a chance for our kids to have that outdoor opportunity that you just don't get. It's like a little wooded section. They planted all these poplars and they're young. You know, they're 10, 12, 13 feet. But even just at that height, you can see it. And I don't know, like even now I'm getting goosebumps. Like there's just something about like this little sense of like urban wilderness. And it's just, it's that moment that you're gonna have to say, hey kids, let's just go walk around here. And I look forward to coming back at night when it gets darker earlier and you can get inside there and just like feel like you're in the woods.
Through the trail, I've connected with my neighbors. We shared a love of transforming this unused space. We all wanted to take down this wall and open it up. Started with the trail, but now we're friends. It's not just a trail. It weaves 3 miles of community together across the city. You're only going up 16, 17 feet, but your spirits are lifted much higher. It's transformative. It's a sacred space.